I'm James Myers from our LePage First Contact Realty, and this is your channel for real estate information in Barrie, Ontario. If you are thinking of buying a house, then this video should be on your must-watch list. Here are 11 tips for new home buyers. Number one, get pre-approved. You've heard this before, you'll hear it again. Get to a bank, mortgage broker, credit union, wherever you're going to get your mortgage from. Sit down with them. They'll want to know your work history, whether you're a job jumper, whether you've been at the same job for 10 years or whatever, how much you make at that job. That's a big part of it. They want to know your credit rating. They're going to run a credit report on you and your down payment, where the down payment is coming from, whether you have saved it up or whether it's coming from RSPs or maybe you're selling your old house and moving into a new house. They want to know all this stuff, and they'll check this stuff all out. And then within a few days, they should be able to give you a number as to what you qualify for a new mortgage or for a mortgage. And who knows, you may be pleasantly surprised. They offer you a bigger mortgage than you thought you were going to get. Number two, do not base what you think you can afford for a mortgage on what you're currently paying for rent. The banks, lenders, and landlords use very different criteria on approving people for a rent or for a mortgage. Years ago, I had a couple, they wanted to buy a house. And so we went out and saw some houses, and I asked them about getting pre-approved in the bank and stuff like that. And they said, oh, we can afford to pay $1,200 a month for a mortgage. And then it turns out they weren't pre-approved. They just thought because they were paying $1,200 a month for their rent that they would get a mortgage that would be $1,200 a month. Well, bank said, sorry, bud, you're not getting $1,200 a month worth of mortgage. They qualified for whatever it was peanuts. They certainly didn't qualify for what they thought they did. So yeah, don't figure because you're paying a certain amount in rent that you can afford that much in a mortgage. Number three, keep your dream list reasonable. I've had buyers come to me over the years with a list, and they say they want, say a triple garage, an ensuite bathroom, four bedrooms, a bungalow on a 60-foot lot, finished basement, hardwood floors, and a big list. So I put all those criteria in the computer. Triple garage, ensuite, hardwood floors, and do a search. And you know what it comes up with? Big fat zero. No houses meet that criteria. So they got to start scratching stuff off the list. Maybe make two lists. One a must-have list, and one a would-be-nice-to-have list. Say you have two small children, and you're looking for a three-bedroom house. You probably want them on the same level as you. So you must have three bedrooms on the same level. And also, you probably don't want a busy street, so you must have a quiet street so they can play outside in the driveway or on the sidewalk or whatever. Stuff like the hardwood floors, the fancy tile, the gas fireplace, that can all be added later. That's a would be nice to have stuff. Number four, buy a house based on the things you cannot change about it. This kind of goes along with the previous tip. And what I mean by this is if you see a flashy renovated house with new modern appliances, a new modern kitchen and granite countertops and hardwood floors and ceramics and all that stuff, but then you go outside into the backyard and there's a 10-story apartment building looking down on you, and there's a factory beside you, you can't change those things. You're stuck with the apartment building. You're stuck with the factory beside you. So you're better off to go and look for a house that isn't as flashy, but it's on a better street, because you can always change your house. You can't change what's around you. Number five, don't try to find the perfect house. It's like a unicorn. It doesn't exist. Instead, use the list that I was talking about earlier, the must-have and would-like-to-have, and grade the houses on a scale of from 1 to 10. Anything above about a 7, seriously consider it, because you can always change stuff about the house and make it pretty close to 10. You'll never find the perfect house. Especially if you're a first-time buyer, use the information you gather from owning your first house to buy your next house. You're going to discover stuff you like about your house, stuff you don't like about it, and that will come in handy when you're buying your next house. Number six, do not use the listing agent of a house to buy that house. And what I mean is, if you're driving around and you see a house for sale and you call the agent that's on the sign, that's the listing agent. Don't do that. Get your own buyer's agent. It doesn't cost you anything 99% of the time. The commission is paid by the seller, and that seller's agent is representing the seller. In Ontario, we are allowed to use dual agency to represent both the buyer and the seller, but you as a buyer, it doesn't cost you anything most of the time to have your own buyer's agent. So you might as well have a buyer's agent representing your interest. And I know you may have heard from people or read in a book somewhere that if there's only one agent involved, you can save some money on the purchase. You can save some of the commission because there's only one agent. Well, everybody involved knows there's only one agent. The seller, the buyer, and the agent. That commission savings, because there's only one agent, the buyer wants part of it, the seller wants part of it, and the agent involved wants, he wants more money because he's doing more work, so he wants to get paid more too. So the amount of savings to be had would be fairly small in my opinion. For the sake of not having your own agent, you might as well get your own agent. It doesn't cost you anything, and your agent will be looking after your interests. Number 7, don't fall in love with the first house you see, or any house for that matter. I know this is hard to do, it's an emotional decision, but in my opinion, there will always be another house come along. I know us real estate agents, you think we're supposed to capitalize on emotional decisions and go for the close when somebody falls in love with the house, but no. Take your time, look at a few more houses, and if the house you fell in love with is still there available after you've looked at a few more houses, then go for it. That's the house for you. Number 8, calculate enough money to cover your closing costs. Closing costs are generally 1.5 to 2% of the purchase price of the house, and they can include lawyer's fees, lawyer's disbursements. If you're getting CMHC mortgage insurance, you have to pay the provincial sales tax, the PST portion of that up front. You may have to pay some property taxes. If the seller of the house has paid his property taxes in full for the year, you have to reimburse them for the property taxes for the part of the year that you're going to own the house. And a big one, land transfer tax. And if you live in Toronto or are buying in Toronto, you have to pay double land transfer tax because the city of Toronto has their own separate land transfer tax. So lucky you. Number 9, after you sign your agreement of purchase and sale and you're waiting for closing, whether it's 30 days, 60 days, or 90 days, or whatever it is, do not go out and buy a bunch of stuff on credit. Like, do not go to the Brick or Leon's or somewhere and buy furniture on a do not pay for a year plan, or buy a new car because you need to get to the job because the job's further away now. Do not buy anything on credit. The bank is going to run your credit bureau, your credit report, just before closing. They're going to check you out again to make sure you still fit their lending guidelines. And if you don't fit their lending guidelines because you've gone out and got an extra payment of $500 a month or something like that, they could turn around and say, sorry, you don't fit our guidelines anymore. We're out of here. We're not going to lend you the money. Number 10, be sure to have funds available to put down as a deposit when you make an offer on a house. When you make an offer on a house and you come to an agreement, you have to put down a small deposit. Now in Barrie, this amount could be anywhere from $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 to $40,000 or $50,000, depending on the price of the house. Now this is not the down payment that goes to the lawyer when you close, the 15 or 20 or 25% down. This is not the same thing. This is money that has to be put down when you write the offer, within a day or so of the offer being written. If you don't get the money to the listing agent right away, you could be at risk of losing the house. So you don't want to be scrambling when the pressure's on saying, oh, I have to move money from this account to this account, or I don't know where to find checks, or I can't get to the bank to get a bank draft because I'm working. You need to think about this stuff now. Where's that deposit coming from? And get it ready up front. Number 11, go see a house you want more than once. I know in some markets it might not be possible. It's a seller's market and there's multiple offers and competition and stuff like that. You might not be able to get back a second time. But if at all possible, if you can do it, go back and see a house again. If you saw it at night, go back and see it during the day. Walk around the outside of it, see the backyard, see how the light shining through the windows, that kind of thing. If you make an offer conditional upon inspection, home inspection, the home inspection is not the chance to go back and decide whether you want this house. You should have already decided that was the house for you before you put the offer in. Home inspection is to determine deficiencies and stuff like that. So, if at all possible, get back and view a house a second time, especially if you saw it in the dark at the first time. I was always told, don't buy a used car in the dark. Well, there you have my 11 tips for home buyers. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up down below. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button as well to receive notifications of my monthly real estate update videos for the city of Barrie. Thank you for watching.